In June 2010, Bill Clinton met with Putin. In July 2010, 10 Russian agents were released by Obama without charges and given a Russian hero's welcome. In June 2010, Bill Clinton met with Russia leader Vladimir Putin. In July 2010, 10 Russian agents were released by Obama without charges and given back to Russia. Putin praised the Russian spies as heroes. It has been widely reported that Bill Clinton flew to Russia in 2010 and was paid $500,000 for giving one single speech. It is also well known that during his trip to Russia, the former president petitioned the State Department to allow him to meet with a key member of the Russia state-owned uranium company Rosatom. The Hill reported in October. As he prepared to collect a $500,000 payday in Moscow in 2010, Bill Clinton sought clearance from the State Department to meet with a key board director of the Russian nuclear energy firm Rosatom, which at the time needed the Obama administration's approval for a controversial uranium deal, government records show. Arkady Dvorakovich, a top aide to then-Russian President Dmitry Medvedev and one of the highest-ranking government officials to serve on Rosatom's board of supervisors, was listed on a May 14, 2010, email as one of 15 Russians the former president wanted to meet during a late June 2010 trip, the documents show. The Hill continued in noting that Bill Clinton instead got together with Vladimir Putin at the Russian leader's private homestead. A short time later, the Obama's administration approved the sale of 20% of U.S. uranium to Russia. The Clinton Foundation walked away with millions and the U.S. lost one-fifth of its uranium to rival Russia. We also now know that the FBI uncovered Russian bribery of the Clintons in 2009 and the Department of Justice and the FBI sat on this for four more years. Worse yet, from a recent report we discovered the investigation was supervised by then U.S. Attorney Rod Rosenstein, who is now President Trump's Deputy Attorney General, and then Assistant FBI Director Andrew McCabe, who is now the Deputy FBI Director under Trump. Mueller is now heading a corrupt investigation into Trump on Russia collusion after being appointed by Rosenstein. This madness was orchestrated under Attorney General Jeff Sessions, who recused himself from Russia-related investigations. Many people are calling for Mueller to step down. What has not been widely reported is that at the time of the Uranium One deal, the U.S. government released 10 Russian agents arrested for espionage. A short time after the former president met with Putin in Russia, these agents were given back to Russia and given a hero's welcome by Putin and not even charged with espionage. The New York Times reported in a separate piece in October 2010 that Russian sleeper agents, arrested in the United States this summer and deported to Russia as part of a prisoner exchange, received top government honors from President Dmitry Medvedev on Monday. Intelligence agents who worked in the United States and returned to Russia in July were among staff members from Russia's Foreign Intelligence Service to receive awards at a Kremlin ceremony, Natalia Dimakova, the president's spokeswoman, told Russian news media. She would not say which awards were given out or whether all 10 of those arrested this summer were among the recipients. The agents, who were arrested in the suburbs of New York, Boston, and Northern Virginia, have been widely lampooned in the West as bumbling caricatures of a bygone era. For over a decade they used false names, invisible ink and other vestiges of the cloak and dagger era to gain access to the type of information more easily downloaded from the internet. In the end they were not even charged with espionage. In Russia, however, they have been praised by Russia's top leaders for their service to the motherland. It now appears that these 10 agents were released as a result of the special meeting Clinton held with the Russians. We really don't know what led to their release, but we do know that Putin treated these individuals like heroes.